it's about.
They get rid of the, like I said, we're beautiful by trying to get rid of the baby and the right down the house. Well, and the very first one is the house out on Lanny Town Road, that's where, that's what got this bridge started, you know, that. Mr. Patterson was a, on that very first bridge, and, the anyway, that was in 2005, December, I was. And, so, but we pay babies all this time, and we don't go out looking for trouble, people have to file a complaint. You pay the baby, they was in 150 yards of the piece of property, we complain about it. And that piece of property has to be abandoned in flat days, and about a year and a half ago, we put down the roof. And, our business has increased for that time. So we have Conway, who were the first ones in town, down from South Street, this is your turn into South Street. And it's on the left, you turn into right to go South Street. And the picture, people lived out there was trying, 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 but they could not get a third signature. Because it was mostly those, stores, houses and stuff. And that, when I said, you know, the one presented a problem, this money paid. And that's, it should present a problem to them with the roads. Now, we worked on this, and had lots of people in the community that said that, not putting them out there, right in the 150 yard boundary of it, the people had to drive Lanny Town Road, it's right on Lanny Town Road. So, but another long story short, our county attorney tried to get something done with the beautification board of the state, because it is on Lanny Town Road, that's a state highway. Well, because of all the cars that were at that point. So we got some help, something happened there, and the cars, most of the cars were removed, but it just showed more junk. So here we say again, cars are not even really saying junk, mate. The brood, I'm sorry, brood. So we still cannot get that third signature. And we are here to ask if the board can be the third signature. And Mr. Coaster has prepared a presentation for you, some slides and some information. I'll just give you that one. So, you're on, Joe.
Okay.
You're here to pay for that.
Okay, the next slide, please. Now, that's the property we're talking about. I'm sure anybody that's driven down,
Lantana Road has seen it. And Nancy told you why we're here. Next slide, please. We have the two signatures, and there's nobody else within 150 yards except South School. So that's why we're here, to see if we can't pony up a third signature. Next slide, please. As Nancy said, there was a junkyard there. There was a couple of vehicles turned over, and we believe that through the auspices of the state, that most of those vehicles have been removed, but unfortunately it uncovered a lot more that you couldn't see because of the vehicles. Next slide. These are some of the earlier pictures that showed a lot of the vehicles. Thank you, much better. And all sorts of cars there, and trash in and around the cars. Next slide. There's an abandoned sofa over there. That would have been a nice place for a rodent, I suppose. And piles of debris in the other slide there. Cars with parts missing. Next slide. There's a camper there, what was left of one. And it was hooked up to a truck, and there was a wheel missing. And in the other slide on the right, you can see some of the stuff around the house. A lot of that stuff hasn't moved in years. Next picture. But just a little bit more of it. And these pictures have been taken over the last year and a half or so. Next slide. So after the removal of the vehicles, we went by and took a few more pictures that will show some of the stuff that was uncovered when the vehicles were removed. Next slide. It's much cleaner in some one regard, but it's really not in others. This picture was taken less than a week ago. Next one, please.
Joe, is this an abandoned house or are there people living in it?
No, there are people living in it. We very seldom ever see anybody, and when I'm taking the pictures, I'm hesitant to strike up any conversations.
In the picture you're taking from the road or the sidewalk, we don't get on the property.
Yeah, we're not allowed to get on the property, so we walk there, and next slide, please. And this is all available right now. You can go down there tomorrow and take a look at it. And the next slide. So, while the properties, many of the vehicles are gone, and what we found with the Health and Safety Standards Board is we'll get a cleanup, and within a short while, it's right back where it was. We have a place in Breckenridge on the on Dunlin Drive that was cleaned up. Judge Warner fined the lady $2,000, and now we're going to have to tackle it again in less than a year. Next slide. So this is what we're requesting of the school board. If we can take that original complaint and have the school board sign as the third complaint, then we can move to get this property cleaned up and to clean up the eyesore, which will certainly improve the situation around there. It has to be a breeding ground for pests and rodents. And I mean, honestly, we don't think the kids at the school should have to see this every day. So. That's our presentation and that's our request. And is there any questions?
I have a question for Mr. Patton.
Sure.
Is there any problem with us signing our name to that complaint that you can see?
I don't think there would be any problem with the board authorizing the director of schools to sign the necessary documents to proceed.
And nothing that would come back on our director as well?
I really don't think so. I've spoken with the county attorney about the situation. I'm familiar with the board and its capabilities of making amendments in the situation. So I don't really see any kind of liability situation if this board sees fit to report it.
Mr. Chair?
Yes.
I move to authorize our director to go ahead and sign the complaint.
Second.
Sorry. Well,
yes.
Ms. Carter, you got the motion. I believe Ms. Boston beat everybody else on the second. Sorry.
I'm sorry.
Everybody understand the motion?
Discussion.
Yes. Well, yes.
Joe, what did the residents of the house say?
We haven't spoken to the residents of the house. Before we do anything, we can't tell them. We have to send them a letter and say there's been a complaint. And that's the first step. We have several steps we have to go through. There's been no contact with them. And generally speaking, if you're looking at a situation like that and you go out to talk to somebody about it, it usually doesn't turn out very well.
I understand.
It's important to know that this is kind of a first step, and several results could come of just the fact that there are three people that are making it. That's what's required to follow.
Mr. Chair?
Yes.
I just think that this is wrong. I think the thing that struck me as close was when you were talking about pests and rodents and being that close to our school. I definitely think that's a health and safety factor for our children, and we need to do it. We have to do it better.
It appears that the owner does not reside there. I'm assuming she uses that as a rental property for whatever reason.
I don't know.
The owner does not reside at that home, so I'm assuming she owns the home. Well, in looking it up, it doesn't appear that she lives there.
So we had a situation on Dunlin Drive where the owner was in Arkansas, and we had to have the sheriff in Arkansas to search for the safety, and she ended up coming here, and that's
we sent a letter just that we got been notified that there is a problem. And our committee is going to meet March 31st at 4:00, and you're welcome to come and meet us. And then if things have not been cleaned up at that time, we will send that letter and say, we are violated. And I had so many days cleaned up, but they could be trying to keep it all as well. And then a lot of times they come, this is what happened, they were driving yesterday, they asked them to come. So we got an additional 30 days, 2 weeks, we got a 30 days. We don't care about the numbers, we don't care about anything except the cleaned up. And that's what the people, the spies, the clients, they just want to clean that.
Is there any further discussion? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion carries.
Okay, I'll have Corey, the mayor's office, get a pass of you, she can run it over here. You know, I was so much in love talking, I like to thank the board for something. I call it COVID money, but you all call it Easter money and all that. But anyway, I am so happy. CCHS is finally getting an auditorium. But they so deserve that, and it wasn't a really good plan. I know Mr. Dixon died, and he probably brought me yesterday. But they brought him all the kids from here, and they're gone. Well, Mr. Collins is building over there. Then it's got cost for a new school. We know that they're probably too. Mr. Dixon got his mom brought Mr. Dixon, and it's not. So I'm getting away 6 years. In 1962,
63. But
thank you.
That's something to do. That's really great. So thank you, Ms. Howard. Thank you, Mr. Coaster. We appreciate y'all coming tonight.
Thank you very much.
Next item on the agenda is the update for CCHS for Jen. We've got a few people here to talk to us. We've got Colonel Trey Meadows, John Hall, who's the principal at CCHS, and we also have Ms. Nancy McInerney. She's a collision repair instructor at the at TCAP, and then Cliff Whiteman also. Who's the director of the TCAP. Thank you all for being here.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. And I do have an outside noise, and I'm afraid of this hider, so I'll use it. So I wanted to take the opportunity to come to you, because I listened to Ms. Boston and said, oh, Lord, I'm afraid of my plea. So I'm just afraid. I'm retired. So, but I wanted to come and do a couple things. So I wanted to thank you all for what you do, because I am a product of Cumberland County Schools. So is Earl Patton over here. So are those people back there. So are a couple of you. So is Dr. Maxwell. And so what you all do and what your predecessors did for the treasures of Cumberland County, our kids, helps us get where we are. So I want to tell you a couple of things about the history of Cumberland County Military. Because if I tried to tell everybody or talk about everybody that's been a product of Cumberland County Schools, that'd be hard. And I don't want to leave anybody else, so I'll just talk about the military. So Cumberland County Schools have produced a combatant commander, a 4-star admiral who commanded Pacific Command, and is also a retired ambassador of South Korea. He only went to the 7th grade out of Wood, but he started here, Admiral Harry Harris. Then you have Kurt Watson. Everybody knows about him. He's on the jet, so that's kind of a part of it. And you have Trish Watson, his sister, who was one of the very early A-4 combat jet pilots in the Navy. And then there's some kid who's part of the president. But, so...
That would be Mr. Trey Meadows.
But all that being said...
The president of the United States.
So all that being said, is Cumberland County has produced a lot we've got a Medal of Honor winner from Crossville. You know, if you watch Sergeant York, Sergeant York came back to Crossville. He wasn't a product of here, but he was also big in education. So education is important, and the things that you do are very important. So I appreciate that. I'm going to put Ms. Boston on the spot just a little bit, because she put it out there, and I told her it's going to cost the country and outside the country that the school board's going to get us a little bit of money for the project. So I hope you did.
Let me put it this way. We brought it up. I brought it up. It passed that. It went to the budget. It has been approved by budget. We are waiting to do, we're doing a contract or an agreement with the city that we will be responsible for the maintenance of that jet or those aircraft, whatever you call it. But we are going to reimburse, I think is what Mr. Wood and I agreed upon, the $8,000 that it's going to cost to buy the pump.
Well, thank you, and I appreciate that. So the project, and I'm going to give you a little bit now, and if you will let me, I will come back late spring, early summer as the project progresses and kind of give you the updates. We'll try to bring a picture, you know, all those slides are for the pool. I'll get John Hall's graphic arts business, because we want this to be a community project.
Yes,
so, you know, I grew up here. I was a sophomore when they put it up, or when they painted it. And so when I was here right after I retired, I saw that Nixon PLC. Then we found out about the Navy. And so we started this project. And so myself, Mr. Hall, with Wyman, President TCAT, we're all Eagle Scout. And so Mr. Magnus' son, he's using part of this as his Eagle Scout project as well. So part of the community. Any of the kids from Seaton, he goes to Stone, good Lord. Mr. Hall is using his kids, his yearbook staff, to help us distribute flyers. The graphic artists have built the flyer that we're putting out. So it's a community effort. TCAT is going to provide the manpower, the labor, to do the sheet metal work, to strip it down, to paint it, to do those kind of things. But it's global, because I've got Blue Angels alumni that are going to come here to do this. We want to bring Kurt and Tricia Watson back and rededicate it at homecoming. So it's a big plan. You all are a part of it. The community is a part of it, and that's what I wanted it to be. So that's what we're at. And we have just over, because I just gave him the check from somebody else, so we're just over $11,000 in private and small business donations. What's yours? So we got enough to do the project. And we just need to raise some more. So 50 years from now, when none of us are here, and somebody else is not standing here to be repainted, because we've taken care of both jets.
That's it.
Yeah. That's it. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. We appreciate it. And I appreciate you not embarrassing me with some old stories.
I was going to say that a lot of my discipline came from a couple of individuals up there. Put your pick on the ping pong table, you will get mad at that. I'm running off to another meeting. I'm talking about the dead fight.
All right, thank you.
Thank you.
I appreciate it.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
All right. It's going to be hard to follow that one. Next item on the agenda is the director's report. I'll turn it over to Dr. Maxwell.
Thank you. It's good to see classmates from a few years ago at CCHS. okay, so the first item, my report is very short tonight. The first item is from Marcia Paulson, our coordinated school health coordinator. This is the youth wellness survey that she administers each year, and she sent a letter as well as a copy of the survey and the information that goes out to parents, and she is here if you have any questions, but it does require board approval.
Second.
Okay, motion, Ms. Pardon. Second, Ms. Handy. Is there any discussion? Yes.
Yeah. This sponsor raised an issue with me, and I thought about it.
He's a very sharp guy. Of course, you don't put a freaking president around without being sharp.
Trying to work you and all.
He was all right.
There are a lot of youths. They didn't have questions. That's not it. And so from that standpoint, I can certainly understand the concern
just say, all right, it's like, don't remember.
That's your call.
Oh, great, look, it's so fucking nice.
It is, it's a voluntary survey.
Parents do not see this survey before they consent to it. So the parents have no idea about questions. They're consenting that their children answer. I think according to Marcia, that's correct, right?
That is right. However, they do follow the team, it's not gonna get us.
Right, if it's anonymous, I don't know that I have a problem with it. I really don't. I just think from a legal standpoint, we're asking some pretty sensitive questions.
Without doubt.
I wanna make sure we're covered.
I don't see any liability concerns the board in this situation. But certainly from the law standpoint, I might have some questions as a parent or as someone advocating for a juvenile. But from the board perspective, it's important information for the citizens to have.
Mr. Safty.
What do you do to inform a student that they're uncomfortable with a question they don't have to answer?
I personally go to the classroom during the time they take the test, and I say just that. Any question you're uncomfortable answering, you do not have to answer. Skip the next one.
Is there a way of putting that in writing?
Okay.
Like a cover page?
Yeah, it's on the right
page.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, Ms. Gardy.
Okay, so my youngest is 18, and as a parent, I would have absolutely no qualms with them answering the survey, even if he was 16, if he was 15. That's number one. Number two, I just think that the data is so incredibly important, because if we get honest answers and they're skewing a certain way, then we are better able as staff and teachers and health department and our nurses to be able to address those particular issues. So I think the fact that it's in writing that you're representing, and I think we talked about this last year too, that this was exactly what happened. I've got no problem with this. I think, and if you're gonna lean on the side of conservatism, your benefit's gonna outweigh the risk.
Well,
little minimal risk there is.
Ms. Polson, this is not the first time we've done this survey, is it? Okay. That's what I had in my mind.
No, we did it. We've done it this 2 years before. I just really went back and started reading those questions and realizing that they were juvenile.
Without a doubt.
And
I get the concern.
I think the concern needs to be there.
Yeah.
Whether the results of the test or the survey comes out and it's positive, I think we have to look at the other side as well. I'm not bothered with it. As long as all says, go.
Is there any other discussion? You're done? We'll vote. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Any opposed? Motion carries.
Okay, the next item that we have is also from Ms. Paulson. And this is the Life Choices maze that she and her partners with the school nurses and other entities did prior to COVID. But at that time, they did seek board approval, and she is requesting that again to do this spring.
Move to approve.
Second.
Okay, hold on just a second. We've got Mr. Safty with motion. Mm-hmm. And Ms. Haney with second. Okay, now discussion.
Is this where they go for the different stations? Okay, no, this is awesome.
Yeah, it will be dependent on my partners at the health department being able to get out to help us with that. But I wanted to have it in the plan because May is my goal closes way before May.
Okay. All right, any further discussion? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion carries.
Okay, and then we have the annual planning calendar, and like I've said, time flies when you're having fun. There are tasks that have been completed, and there are tasks that have been initiated, and so we are moving right along. We'll be beginning budget season's here. And the rest is FYI for your information. And if you have any questions,
can I ask a question? Why was the safety committee a date on there and it's not? It was on the planning calendar for February safety committee. Was I supposed to have had a meeting that I didn't know about?
That's just a holdover from years past.
Okay, I just wanted to make sure I'll tell you this kid under good.
Yeah, I saw that too, and I thought, yeah, I think it's just left over.
Okay, sounds good.
Yes.
Dr. Metcalf, I would just like to thank you and your staff for the SRF group coming. So, and I don't have any wrong, just want to thank you all for your diligence. Thank you.
Anybody have any other questions for Dr. Maxwell? Hearing none, we'll move on. Next item is school board committees. Mr. Tony Brock, the policy committee. Thank you. We could consider approving all three of these if you had an opportunity to look at them. Though I would like to point out, in particular, policy 5.301, we're making every effort to take our support staff and give them as many benefits and thank yous for being an integral part of our whole system. And all this does is open up and give our support staff people the same benefits with bereavement leave, jury duty leave, and others. And I just feel like it's the least we can do, and it's a very low cost, good thing to recognize their importance.
Mr. Brock, may I ask you a question?
Yes, ma'am.
What we had inside the county, we had a situation, and I think this, you took care of it in one of these policies, but I want to make sure. We had an employee that had both parents pass away within a short time, and there was some question as to, did they receive bereavement twice? And I want to, did we clear that up?
We did, even though, honestly, it did require just a little bit of assurance that was the intent of the policy. These were two separate incidents.
Absolutely.
And why or how anybody could face such tragedies, that would be two separate incidents. So two separate issues, so it would be two separate opportunities, forgive the term, of having access to bereavement.
When I read the policy, it looked like that was, but if it ever happens to another employee, I want to make sure that they have the opportunity to take that time to and use that time with their compliments or sentiments or whatever, but I think that was a question. I just want to make sure that was clarified.
I absolutely appreciate you asking that, and I hope that everyone who is around here for future boards, and that this ever comes up, that we have settled that. That was the intent of the policy, and I hope it will forever be that.
That you would have my support on that intent.
Thank you, ma'am. Good question.
I'm not sure.
No, great point, and I appreciate it. The second policy that I'll point out is on personal professional leave. There was an issue there from years ago, and I think that just cleans this policy up a little bit, and also make sure that our principals have some clearer guidelines on granting that, and just to give them some help there.
The other thing is substitute teachers, we just got rid of an outdated, no longer needed portion of that. The rest of the policy really is unchanged. The committee does recommend that you pass on first reading to teachers.
Does anybody else have any questions for Mr. Brock? Hearing none, we'll vote. All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion carries. Next item on the agenda is, which was no second reading, so the next item on the agenda, the athletic committee. Mr. Brock, you got anything from that?
Nothing except some of our recommendations have been passed on for consideration by the budget committee, and everybody knows a lot of times good intentions come down to, do we have the money? So we're studying that.
Okay, thank you. Next is budget committee. Mr. King, do you have anything to report?
I do. Budget committee made a motion on a Blue Angel jet, which we've talked about here tonight. The motion, in essence, was the board will seek to subcontract with the city of Crossville to keep and maintain both the Air Force jet, also known as Miss Nettie, and the Navy jet, also known as the Blue Angel jet, through an acceptable contract to be developed through the board's attorney with a one-time this year donation funding of up to $8,000 for restoration of the Blue Angel jet to come from the general fund with this fund line being coming. So that was the recommendation.
Do we need to vote on this, or do we just need to give direction? Because, I mean, we have to wait on the contract.
I think we have to wait on the contract.
We'll vote on the contract, okay, and then we can proceed. Okay. Y'all been working on that?
Yes, sir.
Good deal. Thank you. Next item is building and grounds. Mr. Sapke, do you have anything to report? Well, I know you don't have anything to report. You've been gone forever.
We are looking forward to bringing the auditorium at CCHS to the building and ground committee at the appropriate time.
Good. Thank you, Mr. Sapke. Contract committee, Mrs. Boston.
We have not had a meeting. Earl and I have talked, and Dr. Maxwell has requested a contract committee. We're trying to set that up. I'm giving Earl just a little bit of time to finalize the fine-tuning of the contract so we can hear them all at once.
Okay.
So we'll have one within the next week or so.
All right. Thank you. Next item is safety committee. Ms. Handy, you got anything to report?
I have not.
Okay. Thank you. Next item is the Chief Financial Officer's report. Ms. Harris, we'll turn it over to you.
Thank you. So you have January's financial statement here. On our revenues page, I wanted to point out a couple lines on the top quarter there. Line 40120 and line 40210. If you notice, they might look a little funny. There was a coding error, and our sales tax was recorded in the trustees' collections for the prior year. That is since being fixed, and it'll reflect that on the February report that I'll give next month. So we did, in fact, receive sales tax money in January. It just doesn't look like it. Then jumping down to the bottom, in January, we received about $5.6 million in revenues for a year-to-date total of about $33.6 against our budget of 56.6. Any questions for you? Looking at our expenditures, in January we spent about $4.2 million against the and for year to date that was $29.2 million against our budget of $60 million. So we're in good shape there. We are really running into a lot of the same problems the average consumer is running into with supply chain issues, wait times, product inavailability, that type of thing. So we are pushing as hard as we can, but sometimes it's hard to get forward. But we'll continue to do that. Any questions? I do not have the sales tax report yet. As soon as I receive that, I'll email that out to the board. That brings us then to, what did you just go on?
Yes.
Sorry.
Yes.
All right, we had one general purpose fund budget amendment. We've got a couple federal, and then we've got a few 143. I'm happy to go over each one if you want.
We just make a motion to approve both three.
Yes, we can.
I make a motion that we approve all the resolutions presented.
Second.
We have a motion, Ms. Boston, second, Ms. Handy. Any discussion? Anybody got any questions on any of them? So we're gonna approve all three of them.
And actually, there's one, there's three.
I'm looking at it from 141, 142, 143. That's where I'm saying all three of them. It encompasses all of them.
Encompasses all the resolutions.
Yes, encompasses all the resolutions.
That's what I'm looking at.
Yeah, okay. Anybody got any questions? Hearing none, since this deals with money, we'll do a roll call vote. Mr. Sam?
Yes.
Ms. Paris?
Yes.
Ms. Hale?
Yes.
Mr. Brock?
Yes.
Dean?
Aye.
Ms. Handy?
Yes.
Ms. Boston?
Yes.
Ms. Harvey?
Yes.
And the chair votes yes. Motion carries. Thank you. Okay, wow. Next item on the agenda is the consent agenda.
Second.
Got a motion, Ms. Harvey?
We got a whole business.
Second, Mr. Dean?
And Ms. Finger?
Any questions?
A question.
Yes.
I just want to ask one particular question. I noticed we had everybody or several schools turn in for volunteers. It's a level one, a level two, and a level three. What are those levels, and who created them, and what did they do?
I'm going to turn that over to Dr. Maxwell, because all I know is they're allowed to do different things in different levels, and that's all I know.
Is this a new thing?
Mm-hmm. I'll let human resources explain.
Okay. Well, maybe we just never put it on the request as a level two, a level three, because I've noticed. And it may have been on there before, and I just didn't notice.
They've always been like that.
Okay, what's a level one?
Level one is somebody that basically is going to put with their child. They're never going to be outside of the school. Level two and three are like the level three are your coaches. People that are going to be left alone with our students or parents that come in and help with us. They're going to be left alone. They're going to probably not feel trips, that thing. So they have a background. Level two people are people that go on field trips and say you go to the Hermitage. And you get off the bus and the teacher says, you've got these eight little boys, we'll see you in 2 hours. And so that parent is left alone without supervision from a teacher or anyone school affiliated with those kids. So therefore they have a background check. State law says that anybody who's in close proximity to a child has to have a background check.
And fingerprint.
And that is the thing.
Okay. But if I'm a level one, I don't.
No, you're supposed to go in with your child, and you've only got your child with you. You're not responsible for any other children. But like if you work in one of our schools, and you're a person that works as a volunteer, pulls a child out of the hallway to work with them alone, you're going to be a tip. And you're going to be fingerprinted with that.
Well, no, when they go into the schools and say, look, I want to volunteer. I want to go on class trips. I want to accompany, you know, my child's classroom, and I'll be glad to help in any way that I can.
They're going to be a tip.
That's what they're going to tell me. This is what you've got to do.
You fill this form out, we give you the paper, the background check. It's going to be $30 if we're back.
Well, I didn't know what each level was either. I just knew that they were allowed to do certain things at certain levels, and I just never asked.
I learned that because I was a level three or a level two volunteer.
Thank you, Ms. Bray. All right. Got any other discussion? Any other questions? All right. We're voting on the consent agenda. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion carries. let me get caught up here. I got extra papers. Okay, next item on the agenda is old business. Anybody got any old business thing to bring up? I've got one thing I need to clear up. Whenever I was welcoming visitors, I missed Miss Kim Wattenbarger. I didn't see you there. Miss Boston had you covered up. I couldn't see you. But thank you for being here.
That was me. I'm the one guarding.
But yes, thank you for being here. We appreciate it. Questions from the media?
No, I'm good.
Okay. Motion to second. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Thank you. Thank you, everybody, for being here. We appreciate it.